See, in previous classes, that is class 10, we solved quadratic equation, isn't it? By a formula method. What was the formula? Minus b plus minus root b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. So this b square minus 4ac we called as discriminant. Isn't it? And what will be the nature of roots? That is decided by delta value. If delta is equal to 0, so we wrote roots are real and equal. If delta is greater than 0, roots are real and distinct, means two different values. If delta is less than 0, roots are not real. Okay, so for this part okay, for this part okay, but this part, roots are not real. This particular answer troubled a mathematician lot. Why this, for this particular delta value, roots are not real? Then what will be the roots of this particular discriminant? So then they discovered that let this be an imaginary number. Okay, so what they proposed, they told that root of minus 1 exists, isn't it? Delta value less than 0 means root b square minus 4ac less than 0 means negative value. So till now we studied root of negative is not exist, isn't it? But after that they proposed that root of minus 1 value is an I, where I is an imaginary number. Particularly it is called as unit imaginary number because here coefficient is 1. 1i or simply I we can say. Okay, so if you take a square root both the side, what you will get? So this is the only number, imaginary number is the only number for which square of that number is negative. Till now we saw that square of any number cannot, any real number cannot be negative. Here I square of I we got as negative number. So these two things you have to remember. Okay, now we come to complex numbers. What are the complex numbers then? So complex numbers are the numbers in the form of a plus bi. Okay, see why they are complex. A and b belongs to a and b belongs to R. Why they are complex number? See, a is, we can say, belongs to R, so real part of complex number. Okay, see, if I is an imaginary number, I is imaginary number, so 2i will be imaginary, 3i will be imaginary. See, but I is unit imaginary. Just now I told 2i and 3i will be imaginary, but not unit imaginary, but they will be imaginary number. Okay, so bi means imaginary part. Imaginary part. So, why they are complex? Because this number include both real part and imaginary part. That's why this form of number is complex number. A plus bi, where a and b belongs to real number. So what we can say? Examples we can see here. 3 plus 2i, 4 plus 5i. Hai na? 3 and 2 belongs to R. But this number is what? Complex number. Okay. And then complex numbers, after this, right, complex number is denoted by z, small z. So therefore what we can write, z is equal to a plus bi. Okay, or some of the examples, so 3 plus 2i, 5 plus 4i, like this we can write definition of complex number. So now we know A plus BI type or A plus BI form is nothing but the form of complex number. And this also we saw A is real part and B is imaginary part. Okay, so these parts are denoted by real Z. That is real part of complex number. Okay, and imaginary of Z means imaginary part. So for example, suppose in question 2 plus 3i, in example 2 plus 3i, okay, real part of Z is what? 2. And imaginary part of Z is 3. Okay, imaginary part means only the coefficient will come, and Z is 2 plus 3i. So after letting this value as Z, we can write real part and imaginary part. Next point is power of I. Okay, now we know I square is minus 1. Suppose find what will be I cube then. So I cube we can write I square into I, but I square is minus 1 into I, so answer will be minus I. So I cube is minus I. Okay, and then find I power 4. This we can write I square into I square, but I square is minus 1, minus minus plus 1. So we can write I power 4 is 1. Okay, then what will be I power 5 then? I power 5 you can write I power 4 into 1 or I power 2 into 3, both values we know here. Okay, so suppose I power 4 into I, 4 plus 1, 5. I power 4 we know now it's 1 and I, so answer will be I. So we got I power 4 is I. Similarly, we can find for I power 6. Okay, so I power 3 into I power 3 into I power 3 or I power 5 into I, since we know I power 5 now. Okay, so this is I into I. So I square is minus 1. So this way you can find values for any power of I here. I power 7 will be I power 6 into I. So I power 6 is minus 1 into I means minus I. Okay, then I power 8 you can find I square into 4. So I square is minus 1 power 4. So if number is negative and power is even, so answer will be positive. That you know, 1 minus 1 minus 1. So minus minus plus minus plus. Okay, so plus we will get. So that we can use method or trick. If power is even, so answer will be positive. So I power 8 is 1. Okay, so one pattern we can observe here. See, this is minus 1 minus I, 1 I. Okay, then minus 1 minus I, 1, and I power 9 will be I. Okay, so see, these four values are repeating itself. That is minus 1 minus I, 1, and I. So this is for power 2, this value is for power 3, this value is for power 4, this value is for power 5, see power 5. Then again this value is for power 6, power 6 is minus 1. Then this is for 7, then this is for 8, this is for 9, see. Similarly this one again will be 10, this cycle is going to repeat. Then this is for 11, then this is for 12, like that it will go on. Okay, So this way we can find any value, or we can remember first few values of I power and we can find other values. For example, I power 100. So I power 100, I can write I square into 50, power 50, isn't it? So I square means minus 1 power 50. So power is even, so answer will be plus 1. So I power 100 is 1. Similarly, for any odd number, suppose I power 35. Okay, so 35 we can write I power 5 into 7. Okay, so I power 5 we know it's I. Okay, so I power 7 we know minus I. This way also we can do. So first few values if we remember we can find. Or see, suppose I power 5 you don't know here. So what you can do, you can split odd power into even power. Suppose 35 you can write I into 34 into I. Then I power 34 means I power 2 and 17 into I will be same. I square is minus 1, 17 into I. Power is odd, negative answer, negative power will give negative answer into I. So answer is minus I, see. So no need to remember for this also I power 5. Till here only these three value if you remember, that will be more than enough. Next is equality of two complex numbers. So suppose one complex number is a plus ib and another one is c plus id, where a, b, c and d belongs to real number. Okay, so suppose if I write z1 is equal to z2, these two real complex numbers are equal. That means a plus ib is equal to c plus id. So when they can equal? When real part of the first complex number equals to real part of the second. Okay, imaginary part of the first real complex number equals to imaginary part of the second complex number. Okay, so when this will happen, we can say two complex numbers are equal. So this we can use this concept to find value of x and y. Suppose x minus or directly x I plus x minus y I. Okay, this equals to 2 plus 3 I. So find x and y. Suppose this example. So here we can use this concept. Both these complex number are equal, means imaginary part and real part will be equal. So real part if we equate, so x value you will get directly x equal to 2. Imaginary part of this complex number is equal to imaginary part of other complex number, but x value we got 2 already, so minus y is equal to 3 minus 2, so answer is minus 1. So this concept we can use to find variables. Algebra of complex number. So first operation is addition. Okay, so let z1 a plus ib, z2 c plus id, two complex number. Okay, so addition will be, see, as we are adding in linear equation in two variable, like terms only we are adding, isn't it? Suppose x plus y and 2x plus 3y, this equation we should add. So what we will do, we'll add both x term and both y term, isn't it? So here also in the same way we should add real part and imaginary part. So z1 plus z2 means a plus ib plus c plus id. So what you should add, a and c, okay, and ib and id you should add. So I we can take common, so b plus d you should take. Okay, you should add. So z1 plus z2 is a plus c plus I times b plus d. Now if you observe here, addition is again one complex number. Okay, so what we can say, property, closure property or closure law, sum of two complex number is again complex number. So closure law holds true under addition. Sum of two complex number is also complex. Okay, that means closure law holds true for addition. Now commutative law. Okay, so for any two complex number, see this C set is for complex numbers. Any two complex number, Z1 plus Z2 will be equal to Z2 plus Z1. Okay, this condition also will be true. So suppose 2 plus 3i and 5 plus 6i. So what we will do, 2 plus 5 7, 6 plus 3 9i. Or else first you write this number, then this, then also answer will be same. So after interchanging also answer will be same. So commutative law is also true under addition. Then associative. So associative means Z1, Z2, Z3 belongs to complex number set. So Z1, Z2 plus Z3 you can write, or Z1 plus Z2 you can solve, then add Z3 in that. You will get the same answer. Next is additive identity. Let Z1 belongs to any number. So if you add 0 in Z1, you will get Z1 only. Okay. Now see, Z1 is complex number. What about 0? Is 0 complex number or real number? See, any real number we can write in the form of complex number. 0 we can write 0 plus 0i. Okay. 2 we can write 2 plus 0i. So any real number we can write complex number. So we can say every real number is complex, but vice versa is not true. Every complex number is not the real number. Okay. So here Z1, for example, Z1 is 2 plus 3i. So 2 plus 3i plus 0 plus 0i. So 2 plus 0 is 2. 3 plus 0 is 3i. Okay. So answer will be same. Z1 only. So that's why 0 is additive identity. Okay. Now next is additive inverse. Additive inverse. So here also let Z belongs to C, any complex number. So additive inverse of Z will be denoted by, it is denoted by minus Z. Why? Because see, after adding this number, we will get additive identity, 0 here. We can check this also. Okay, suppose Z is 3 plus 2i. So minus Z will be minus 3 minus 2i. So add these two number. So 3 plus 2i minus 3 minus 2i. See, 3 minus 3, 2i minus 2, answer is what? 0. Okay, so whenever this expression true, answer is 0, that means this minus Z is additive inverse of Z. So minus Z is the notation for additive inverse. Second operation is difference. Difference of two complex number. So let Z1, Z2 belongs to complex number set. Okay, so Z1 minus Z2 will be what? Adding the inverse of Z, additive inverse of Z2 in Z1, isn't it? We can write this as minus Z2. Okay? So, we can take example, suppose 5 plus 6i and Z2 is 3 plus 2i. So, Z1 minus Z2 will be 5 plus 6i minus 3 plus 2i. So, 5 minus 3 means 2 and 6i minus 2i means 4i. Okay, so this will give Z1 minus Z1 difference of two complex numbers Z1 and Z2. Third operation is multiplication. Okay, so in multiplication also, suppose Z1, Z2 belongs to two complex number. So Z1, Z2 will be multiplication of two numbers. So A plus IB, suppose Z1 is A plus IB, Z2 is C plus ID. Okay, so A plus IB into C plus ID. So same method we will use here. We will open the bracket first using A. So AC plus ADI, ADI. Then here with IB we will open, so BCI plus BDI square. But I square is what? We know minus 1. From these two we take break, can take I common, so AD plus BC. And I square is minus 1, so minus 1 into BD means minus BD. So AC minus BD plus AD plus BCI. So this way we can find multiplication of any two complex number. Now if you observe here, this is again one complex number, this is real part, imaginary part with imaginary number I. So what we can say, first property, closure law also holds true for multiplication. So first property, closure law, product of two complex number is a complex number again. Okay, so closure law holds true for multiplication also. Then we have commutative, associativity and distributive. So second one is commutative law. So Z1, Z2 belongs to C. So we can write Z1, Z2 or we can multiply Z2, Z1. We can interchange and multiply. Answer will be same. Then associative. Means Z1, Z2 for three complex number. Z1, Z2 you multiply, then multiply with Z3. Or Z1, Z2, Z3 you multiply, then multiply with Z1. Answer will be same. Then multiplicative identity. In real number also we have multiplicative identity as 1. So in complex number also. Suppose Z belongs to C. So Z into 1 will be Z, isn't it? Therefore 1 is multiplicative identity. Now here 1 is what? Complex number or real number? So 1 is also complex number because we can write 1 plus 0 I. Okay, so now next one is multiplicative identity over multiplicative inverse. So let Z belongs to complex number. So 1 by Z is multiplicative inverse. Because when we multiply these two numbers, we will get multiplicative identity, which is 1. So Z into 1 by Z is 1. So therefore 1 by Z is multiplicative inverse. And then distributive law. for any three number. Z1, Z2 plus Z3, we can write Z1 into Z2 plus Z1 into Z3. Okay, so this way, or Z1 plus Z2, Z3 is outside in multiplication. So we can write Z1, Z3 plus Z2, Z3. Both ways correct. Next is division of two complex numbers. So let Z1 and Z2 belongs to complex number set. So division is denoted by Z1 by Z2, where Z2 is not equal to 0. Okay, we can take one example. Suppose Z1 is 3 plus 2i and Z2 is 1 minus 1 plus i, suppose. So Z1 by Z2 will be 3 plus 2i. Now this is the rule. Since in rational numbers also, root term should not be there. So we have to rationalize the denominator. So here also, in complex number also, 1 plus I term should not be there in denominator. Means imaginary number should not be there. So we should rationalize this. So there also conjugate was there. Here also conjugate is there. So 3 conjugate of the denominator is what? 1 minus I. So from 1 minus I, we will multiply and divide. Okay. So numerator, multiplication of two bracket we will get, and denominator we can use identity. See, a plus b, a minus b. So we can write a square minus b square. Okay, and this we can product of two complex numbers. So we can open the bracket. So 3 minus 3i plus 2i minus 2i square. And here if you observe, I square is minus 1. Minus is already outside, so minus minus plus, that is 2. So answer will be, see, minus 3 plus 2i means minus I. And 3, this is I square is minus 1 plus 2. 3 plus 2 means 5 divided by 2. So what we can write? 5 by 2 minus I by 2. So this is again one complex number with real part 5 by 2 and imaginary part 1 by 2. So division also gives complex number in division of complex.